In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a simple design with heartbeat lines, like this one right here. Let's go. What is up, Detour Nation? Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juna with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005. If that's something you want to learn how to do, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Hit that subscribe button. So in this video, I'm doing it again. I'm doing another trend from this video right here. This time, I'm gonna show you how to do the dirt bike heartbeat design. So it's gonna look a lot like this t-shirt right here. And I'm gonna show you very simple steps on how you can do it in Affinity Designer. So hopefully this video is really helpful for you. You're gonna wanna stay till the end so that you can see how to do it from start to finish. Stay till the end for that, as well as another edition of trend credits at the end of this video where I show you a different trend that you can use for merch by Amazon and possibly Redbubble as well. So stay tuned for that. Lots to see in this video. So I'm gonna go mostly into Affinity Designer. So let's get into Affinity Designer right now. So here we are in Affinity Designer, and I'm gonna show you how to make this heartbeat right here. And it's gonna be really simple. All we're gonna use is the pen tool and the node tool. So pen tool right here, and node tool, this white arrow right here. So first the pen tool. Let's click on the pen tool here and do a line. So just click here and then hold down shift and click somewhere down here. So just making a straight line. You may not have any color on it. You can see mine is fill none and stroke none. So click on the stroke right here of the color and make sure that it's black. And your stroke may be thinner than this. And a way you can change that is to go to stroke right here and adjust your width. So you can make it thin, you can make it thick. I'm gonna make mine just right here like that. So mine is at 5 points, yours may be different. Okay, so next thing you're gonna do is click on the node tool right here, N-O-D-E. And we're gonna make 7 points. So that's what this is showing you, 7 points. I already have 2 here, so I'm gonna do 7 more. Just clicking them in the middle here, just randomly one after the other. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And they don't have to be spaced out at any length or any, we're gonna move them so it doesn't matter. They can be anything, we can just move them later. So first, the first one right here, the first of the 7 that you did on the left, starting on the left, don't move it. We're gonna pick the second one and we're gonna move that up. So what we're gonna do is just like this one, up, then down, then up, then down, then up, then down, okay? So the first one's gonna be up like this, and the second one, or the third one here, is gonna go down. So you're just gonna move it down like this. There's no real scientific way to do it. You're just eyeballing it. You know, you can move it like this, or you can move it like that, whatever it is. The fourth one is gonna be higher than the rest, so just like that. The fifth one right here, you're gonna go down a little bit. And then the sixth one is you're gonna go up just a little bit. And again, you can move these in. If you wanna move them across on this line, these last two, the first and the last, hold down shift while you're doing it so you can make sure that they're straight so you don't put it up like this. So it will kinda lock there. It won't specifically lock, but it will help you make sure that it's straight. So if you wanna come in a little bit, push it in here, hold down shift while you move it in. And you can kinda just move these around, right? There's no like wrong or right. This one's definitely higher, the middle one. So the first two are lower, and then these two can come down and up. So you can see this one's slightly different than this one, and that's okay. They don't have to be perfect. They just have to be, you know, up, down, up, down, up, down, okay? So move it to how you want it, and that's it. Just a heartbeat, and you can see it here. So we're gonna do 3 heartbeats, or you're gonna copy this. We're gonna copy this 3 times. And the way you're gonna do that is bring in the points here with your node tool at the end of it. So you can hold down shift again to make sure that it's straight. Bring it in. And then we're just gonna hold down this one and hold down option and shift and drag. So while you hold down option, shift and drag, it's copy. Actually, option and drag is copy. Shift is just to make sure that it's on a straight line, okay? So let's do that again. I'm gonna zoom out actually. So command minus zooms it out once. And let's move this here, here. So just move these where you want them. If you see this happen right here, where this one is further along and it kind of cuts into the other one, just double click on it and click that last one, hold down shift and you can move it, okay? So that they're closer. So they're just three separate ones. You can see 1, 2, and 3. So once we have this, we're gonna put our design right here, our motorcycle, our dirt bike, or whatever we're gonna use, we're gonna put it right here, and that's our next step. So let's go and find a motorcycle and I'll show you what to do next. So one place I like to look for art is Merch Informer, since I already have a subscription to Merch Informer. There's Merch Informer graphics right here, and you can see there's tons of graphics. If you're already subscribed to this, you might as well use this. And I really wish they had like a search on here so you can actually search for it and then just download that instead of downloading all of it. I downloaded all of it, but it is in June 2020. It doesn't show it here. I'll show you later in the video. You can see there's a motorcycle like this. There's also a dirt bike. If you don't have Merch Informer and you want it, I do have a link in the description for it. You can click on that. But if you don't have that, I would suggest go to Creative Fabrica and type in dirt bike. Let's look at that. And you can see there's several dirt bikes here. There's actually a dirt bike with the heartbeat here that you can buy for $199, so you don't even have to do the heartbeat. But there's also a lot of different PNG bundles, dirt bikes, and things like that. So I would go there. The one we are gonna use for Merch Informer is just a dirt bike. It looks very similar to this one right here. So you could use that too, but you can see dirt bikes are a thing on here. So if you wanna get that dirt bike, I'm not gonna teach you how to draw a dirt bike in Affinity Designer. That is gonna be really tough to do. There's not a real simple way to do that. It's kind of more of an advanced technique to draw that in there. So unless you're a really good illustrator, I wouldn't tell you to draw your own dirt bike. It's just gonna take way too long, a lot of details in a dirt bike. So get your dirt bike from here, get your dirt bike from Merch Informer, or wherever you want, and then I'm gonna go back into Affinity Designer and show you how to use those assets. So here's the dirt bike I got from the June 2020 vectors on Merch Informer. You can see it has some color and we don't need all that color. So we're just gonna make it a silhouette. And one way you can do that is to select it all here and then go into your layers palette. And this is all of them right here, the curves. And I'm gonna turn all the colors to black. So come here and just turn it all to black. And you can see it pretty much does that. So you're gonna see some gray outlines here, and that's just because there's different shapes. So one way to do it is to make it one shape. So select all of them again, and I'm gonna hit down add here. So you can see here it's adding all the shapes together, and that's just gonna make it easier. It's gonna take some time to do it, so I may speed this up, but I'm gonna hit this now to see how long it takes. So now that you see that it added everything, there's not a lot of gray spots, and if you want to clean it up, you can just draw in with the pen tool or your pencil tool and just kind of fill it in. So I'm going to fill these in right here just so there's not any other white spots, and put black on there and make sure that it's black, and I can merge that with everything else too again. So let's do that. Anyway, that's close enough. So the thing I wish was on here was a person riding the bike, and we can fake that. So I'm gonna try and fake it for you really quick here. Let's move this down. I'll show you what I did. Here's my fake version of it. So let's put this down and let's see if we can do it again. So I'm gonna make this smaller, just holding down shift so I keep the proportion the same. And you can see I just lifted the bike. So all I have to do is turn it a little bit like this, right? And the person I drew here is really simple. So let me show you how I did it. So we want the head, which is a round shape, kind of. So I'm taking the round circle here, just making a circle right there. So really simple. So I'm gonna put it right about there. We also need a body and leg and some arms. So I'm just gonna use this ellipse just to give us a shape, right? And let's turn it. The body's gonna be, you know, kind of bent like that. And the legs, let's do another ellipse like this. kind of a leg. This isn't going to be perfect, so let's just do like that. And then copy that leg and make it the arm. That's a really big arm. We're going to make it skinnier. And kind of turn it kind of near the handlebars, so it has to be grabbing the handlebars. Right there. So it kind of looks like it, right? It almost looks like just one of those line drawings. So let's make it just a little bit better. Maybe the head's a little too big. Let's make it down like that. Okay, so the person needs to be wearing a helmet and the arms need to be having a shape, and we need a more butt and legs here. So let's just use this as guides. I'm gonna select all these, change it to lines, and take the stroke down just so it's guides here. Right, like that. So those are my guides to draw. And I'm just gonna group that so we have that later. Now, here's the real thing that I'm gonna do. With the pen tool, I have the pen tool selected. I'm gonna go here and draw my helmet just around like that. Right, I'm gonna just fake it. I'm holding down control right here to lock it. And let me zoom in so you can see what I'm doing with the helmet. So zoom, command, plus, and just bring this down here. So helmet kind of comes down like this, right? And goes in, and then comes down like that. And then we have kind of that mouthpiece like this. So hold down control on this one, mouthpiece out like that, and come here. And then the arms, let's just come down here, and we have to have him grabbing it. So let's put like a hand here, really simple. And then the arms will come up like this, right? And the body will come in, so he's not, doesn't have a stomach. Let's come in a little bit more. The legs will come in like this. Let's just, you won't see that, so come out. And we're gonna need like his butt to come out, so let's do that. Right, like he's sitting up. And just follow this line and curve it up like this. And there. So now that we've filled that in, let's fill that in with color. And we can kind of adjust it if you want the helmet to be a little bit better. Again, we're just faking it. This is just a silhouette. It's gonna be really small. We can move that down and up. However you wanna like move it around. So you can see it's kinda like the hands are grabbing it here, right? And his arm. So we just use that as a guide. And move things around if you want. Maybe his butt's not this saggy, maybe it's up like that. But his legs are coming in like this, right? Good, now we can get rid of the guides that we had. So that guide. And there we go. There's a person, really simple person on a bike, right? And it's a little different than this one. If you wanna, you know, his back to arch, you can kinda come up here and take his back out and arch it a little bit more if you want, stuff like that. You can have his chest come out, whatever it is, but you can see it really is just a shadow. So it doesn't have to be anything too complex. You have the bike that looks like a bike. This person can just be really simple. And you saw that I just did that with the pen tool, kind of eyeballing it. So that's how you can do that. Let's take this shape and put it on our heartbeat, and I'll show you how to do that. So here we have both things that we made earlier. So the heartbeat, we have this right here. Remember, there's the three of these. So one, two, and three. And then we have the dirt bike. Let's just group these together now. So I'm hitting Command G, so this is one thing. And we're just gonna size it down. So we just have to grab the corner here and shrink it down just a little bit. So we want the tire here and the tire there. So let's just do that, kind of eyeballing it. You'll notice the line again on this heartbeat is over that. So let's zoom in. I'm gonna Command plus, I'll show you what I'm doing. So double click on this. And you're gonna use that node tool right here and just hold down shift and bring it in right where the tire is. So you can see right there. Same thing with this side, bring it in to the tire. So you can see that it's just doing that. So that's all there is to it. So you're done right here. There it is. Heartbeat with dirt bike. So simple. And I showed you this, but I also wanted to show you can do it with other things. In my other video, I'm gonna put another video right here. I show you how to do these balls, baseball, soccer ball. You can do that as well. Put that in there. And the thing you might want to do as well is to make it white. So here's a black background. I'm just turning these white. Just you can see that this one is white. So let me show you how to do that. I'm going to take our thing that we just made right here. I'm going to drag it or copy it. Command C and put it on this black background. Command V over here. So you can't see it because it's black. So because the background is black, I'm gonna turn this gray so you can see what I'm doing. So here, these two, three, it's a stroke right now, so you can make that white stroke instead of a black stroke. So this one is a shape, so let's just take this one and it's the fill and turn it white, and there it is. You just turn that to white and save this, export this as your file, make sure that it's the right size. And then you can use it on Merch by Amazon or Redbubble or wherever you want. So I'd still keep this black version as a sticker. So these may be really good stickers on Redbubble. But if you want a t-shirt on a black t-shirt, we saw a lot of the t-shirts were black, convert it to white here. So that is it. That's all you need to do. I showed you how to make the heartbeat lines as well as the dirt bike. You can use this for anything, any sport, any hobby. Be creative with this. All you need is a silhouette here or some kind of black and white drawing, and you can do it, have your own different niches on this. So hopefully this video is really helpful for you. Let me know in the comments if it was. Thanks so much for staying till the end, and your reward for staying all the way till the end is another edition of Trend Credits. Thanks for joining me on this trend. Here is your trend: violates community standards. Take a look at these. Not sure why this is trending. Let me know in the comments if you know why this is trending. I'm guessing Facebook community standards or some other community standards. Take a look at these low BSRs. Take a look at these. This one's even getting low BSRs, and it's really hard to see. So not sure why low BSR here. I mean, not all of them are selling. Like some of these, they may be new. Maybe they didn't get any sales yet. So, but there's still some with some low BSRs. Let's take a look at Merch Informer. It's getting an A, so you know it's good. If you don't have Merch Informer, I have a link in the description for Merch Informer where you can check competition like this and get your Merch Informer graphics like we used in this video. So take a look at this trend again. Violates community standards. I think you can break into this one pretty easy. Like the competition is mostly text. So if you do something that gets people's attention, I think you can get more sales than the ones that are already here. So this is your trend for this video. Have fun with this one. Violates community standards. So that is it for this video. Thanks so much for watching. Hopefully this video is super helpful for you. Now you know how to make those heartbeat designs. And if it was really helpful for you and it brought you lots of value, make sure to give it a thumbs up. It really helps with the algorithm. And if you're not subscribed already to this channel, hit that subscribe button. I got one right in the corner right here in all my videos, so you can make sure to click on those. And before I leave, I wanted to leave with a question of the day. And the question of the day is related to this video. What would you put in your heartbeat design? Instead of a dirt bike, maybe you're gonna put a soccer ball or a golf person or, you know, swimming. What hobby do you like? What things do you really love? Let me know in the comments, what would you put in your heartbeat design? Put that in the comments. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.